A 4.42 cubic meters insulated rigid tank contains 4.8 kilograms of carbon dioxide at 90 kilopascals. A paddle wheel is used to provide the system with work until the pressure in the tank rises to 135 kilopascals. Determine the entropy change of carbon dioxide during this process. Assume constant specific heat. As usual, pause here to solve this problem yourself before watching the solution. This is the first example for the reference entropy and specific heat's main lecture. The link to that 12-minute lecture and all the other examples and lectures of the thermodynamics course are found in the description below. From what we covered in the main lecture video, you already know that there are two expressions that allow us to calculate entropy changes for when we assume constant or average specific heat. And remember that constant or average specific heats correspond to the approximate slash variable slash inexact analysis. The first expression is in terms of the specific heat at constant pressure, Cp, and in terms of the pressure values, which we have. And the second expression is in terms of the specific heat at constant volume, Cv, and in terms of the volumes. Now, you might think that since we don't have the volumes, we should go with the first one, but what we need is the ratio between volumes, and since this is a rigid tank, V1 is equal to V2, and therefore V2 over V1 is 1, and natural log of 1 is 0. This means that the second expression is actually quicker to calculate. But still, let's solve it using both expressions, just to compare the results. Additionally, regardless of which one we use, we need the ratio of the temperatures. We didn't receive any temperature information, but since CO2 is an ideal gas, and the volume is constant, T2 over T1 is equal to P2 over P1. So T2 over T1 is just 135 over 90, or 1.5. Now, we weren't given the temperatures, but that doesn't mean that we cannot calculate them. And we do need to know the temperature so that we can take an average specific heat value. Since we're dealing with an ideal gas, we can calculate the temperatures as PV over MR, with R being the gas constant for CO2. Substituting the values, we find that the temperatures are 240.2 and 360.3 Kelvin. In the main lecture, we highlighted how the average of specific heats at two temperatures is not the same as the specific heat at the average temperature. But since this is a small difference, it's fair to take Cv and Cp at 300 Kelvin. So we go to our 300 Kelvin table for specific heats and write those down. We substitute the mass, Cp, temperature ratio, the gas constant for CO2, and the pressure values in the first expression, and we substitute mass, Cv, and temperature ratio in the second expression. And we get the same 1.279 kilojoules per Kelvin value for both. And that's the total change in entropy. Now try solving this problem using the exact solution and compare your results. Which one is quicker or more precise? If you want to check out other examples for the reference entropy and specific heats topic, make sure to check out the links I left down in the description below, where you'll also find the links to the other lectures of the thermodynamics course, as well as other engineering courses. Thanks for watching!